This is Josh Reaves, and this is a day in the life.
How was the recruiting process?
A great experience to go through. Like, it's something that you probably, as a kid, don't think you would go through, especially like where I come from and like things I've been through throughout my basketball career. But just like all the teams and, you know, schools that recruited me, coaches that talked to me, just to have a whole list of schools, it was actually like just love, like appreciation that they had for me.
How would you describe your support system?
Very, very supportive. Obviously, my parents are first. They've been with me since I was five doing this. You know, all the money they invested in me, the traveling, you know, the debates, the arguments. It got me very far. And sometimes we, as a group, as a family, we didn't think I'd probably be here.
Your plans for when you touch down at the mount?
To honestly just focus and lock in. It never was in my parents and I mind, oh, probably my mother, but to like go to the NBA. And now that I see that I have a chance, obviously being at the next level and, you know, playing high major teams, you know, I'm gonna put the phone down, social media down, and the texting down, and just lock in, just do what I have to do.
Who do you idolize your game after?
Really, I have my own game. My father really like taught me everything I needed to know. I was talking to everybody like, before this, and I couldn't shoot a three-pointer until I got into high school. Like, if I shot a three-pointer in middle school, he would get on me about it. So I guess I just like started. I was just attacking right and left, and then, you know, I started to get a mid-range. I got a mid-range before I shot a three-pointer. And then, you know, I just developed it and just kept developing on it. And then my three-pointer started developing and I started shooting that. I remember people used to say, like, when I used to hit the three, it was an NBA three. Like, what? I didn't know what that meant. Like, I was like, all right, if it goes in, it goes in. But now, in this day and age, you know, it's just the mentality that I really idolize, like Kobe, you know, Kawhi on the defensive end, probably, and LeBron, probably, not on the basketball court, but outside of basketball. I don't really want to compare to LeBron James because he's just wearing different shoes, you know what I mean? So I don't really idolize my game after anybody. I just like try to have my own game, and I'm going to continue to do that.
Feel any pressure going to the next level?
I actually don't feel pressure. Me and my dad always talk about it, you know. He always asks me when we watch these games, can I play on that level? Do I see myself playing on that level? I say, yeah, it's just basketball. At the end of the day, you gotta tie your shoes just how they tie their shoes. It doesn't matter, you know. At the end of the day, you gotta put the ball in the hoop and try to lead your team to a win. So pressure for me is out. I've been through enough in my lifestyle, you know, and I'm only 18. And I know there's going to be more obstacles to go through, so pressure, that's not even in my vocabulary.
How did the game of basketball impact your life?
I mean, I've been watching my brother play in high school at Hampton High and just listen to the stories about my uncles and my father, obviously. Everybody in my family played basketball. My sister played basketball. I watched her. My other brothers play basketball, except for two of them. And I just been around the game for so long that I just started idolizing watching the game back and forth like this since I was three. It just impacted my life on another level. You know, I get to say, like, only 1% of people go to college for free to play this game of basketball. And I get to say I'm one of them. And it's just a blessing, you know. Not everybody gets to go to college for free and, you know, become successful and do the things that I accomplished that I never thought I would accomplish. I remember when I was in middle school going to Mohegan Sun to watch St. Joe's play the championship, state championship, and just wanting to be on that stage. And it's just crazy to me how I actually was on that stage my sophomore and junior year. Obviously, I lost my sophomore year, but just to be there was amazing. But I knew I had to get some revenge my junior year. And I won my junior year, went 27-0 in the state, and we won. So it's just amazing to experience things that I experienced, play on courts I never thought I would play on, and meet people I never thought I would meet, and things like that. So it has a big impact on my life, and you know, I just hope it continues.
What are your plans for your senior year, your last year of basketball at the high school level?
I'm just trying to kill everybody in my way. Obviously, people would just lower themselves to sleep since they got the offer, and you know, probably committed, maybe, or about to. But I'm just trying to kill everybody. That's the plan. I'm not thinking about that now.
My guys,
brother, go do what?
Get some food. Stay tuned.
Cause I don't know if I'm getting. That's alright.
She's. Who's your favorite basketball player?
Basketball player?
Yeah.
That's hard. I don't know. Oh, De'Aaron Fox. He's tough. I like him because of his speed and the way he finishes around the rim. He got the three-pointer a little bit. Mid-range Kawhi, obviously. Because I got a mid-range game. So.
You got that, but it's not LeBron.
Not really. It's not really LeBron. He's 6'9". I'm 6.
I don't mean he can't be your favorite.
No. Can't be.
Play anybody, dead or alive, one-on-one, who would it be?
LeBron. Kevin Durant. Definitely Trae Young. Ja Morant. I have a lot, etc. Ja Morant. I play anybody. I want to play anybody. Everybody.
How much time do you put into basketball?
Hours. Probably since last year, you know, going to a prep school, I have more like free time. Like I have less classes, so I can just, whatchamacallit, I got more time to practice and work on my game and stuff like that.
Go.
Where I was born and was raised, man.
Really, here,
especially over there on that side, New Haven. Camden High right there. I live up here. You know. Actually peaceful. GameStop, always there. Always get my games from there. Ashley's ice cream. Definitely top five ice cream. Right now we're going to Marshall's. I have no idea why. I'm not getting nothing. You know me, I keep the drip on me. Expensive drip. Nah, chill. Expensive. I got the SKS gear on me right now. Some smooth slippers.
What is the difference between Notre Dame and South Kent?
Notre Dame, like, it was like, I didn't have too much gym time. You know, we kind of try to like sneak in there sometimes. I wasn't really, I don't think me personally, I wasn't prepared for college. As soon as I got to South Camp, I started to like get prepared for college, lose a lot of weight and stuff like that, and just get my game and then like correct and stuff. So, yeah, that's really cool.
When did you realize that you could play at the next level?
I always knew I could. It's just, it was just a matter of a school giving me a chance, coaches giving me a chance. You know, I really like, I had no offers, I had none. I'm a fifth year senior, and this spring and summer, I really like sort of blew up in my own way. But other than that, freshman through my regular like senior year, I didn't have any offers, no interest, no nothing. And if I did, It came and it went. So I kind of knew after this summer that I could play on the next level. And I just been working on my game ever since then, doing what I need to do.
Jackson.
Great eats.
Very great eats. Have a bath.
All right. Let's forget.
Okay.
Of course. You gotta have hot sauce on that.
Boy,
you gotta have the hot sauce?
Yes, bro.
Bro, you got mild and hot already.
And some Tabasco sauce.
Okay.
Nah, I got questions.
These niggas crazy.
Bro, you see me, man. I just get my food now. I'm gonna eat it. It's all going down the same way. Yes, sir. We just came from Chipotle. You know my body. About to get to it. My bag somewhere over there. Look. Yes, sir.
All black.
It's another part of H-Town. It's a nice part. Got the bellies right here. It's a nice day, bro.
Where
you
walking
to? Where you
walking
to?
Where
you
about
to get stuck?
Gotta be a
ski. That's why they're called class clowns.
This is about to hit different, bro.
What you say?
This is about to hit different.
You got a bath though? Don't eat nothing.
Oh, I'm not eating nothing. I'll wait until we get to your
crib.
We got snow bath.
I ain't touching nothing.
I'm gonna be honest.
Evan's the only one here with.
I got the crib.
Yes, we're back.
Where we at? Josh,
what you want to say?
Well, where we at?
None of them have belts. None of them have belts.
Yo,
hold my phone, bro. Hold my phone. You never want to hear it.
What you about to pull out the bag?
Watch. Look.
Oh my god. Oh,
yo, I catch some alley in up. My bounce is unnormal.
I don't know what we got here.
Bro, this is my document.
Full pocket though. No, we're coming.
Yes, sir.
No. Got drip on me.
Now, I'm calling it right now. That shit is going to say 12, 40 on him and on him. Gavin Green, Justin, whatever his last name is. Something.
Kyle Washington.
Who's that?
Damn.
But the main focus is this man right here.
No, this is it, man.
The main focus.
Ready to go?
Are you ready? Yes, sir.
We'll start in about 2 minutes while we get the guys together.
Alright.
It's gonna get there, but you're gonna have to continue to work because this is not easy. And we stayed in touch. He played for me at the AAU level. He decided he needed to go somewhere else probably to play against higher level competition. And he came to me as a man. And I said, whatever you think's best, you go ahead and do that. How dare you leave? And you're never gonna play for me again, I'll teach you. That's just not who I am. and that's not who he was, and he treated it the right way, and then he came back. I don't even know. When did you come back? Probably right around January or February, he said, I want to play for DTX.
Yeah.
And I remember sitting with you and your father over here, having a heart-to-heart, and I told you what I think you're going to need to do, and the rest, as they say, is history.
So the work is just beginning. So, Josh, we're proud of you. Love you, man. Good luck. And we're proud of you, man. Come on up there, Josh.
I just want to thank, you know, the man above first for all the blessings he has brought upon me throughout my journey. And I would just like to thank a lot of people behind the scenes, behind my success so far. Coach Mitch Oliver, who is one. He's the head coach at Albertus Magnus for the boys. And Coach Tina, obviously, Coach Roman, my high school coaches, Coach Bill Barton and assistant Coach Kyle. You guys pushed me and elevated my game each and every year, and I don't think I would have, you know, a piece of their knowledge into my game, you know, if it wasn't for them. And, you know, the gym access, you know, here at InSports, I would just like to thank InSports for just letting me just walk in here and just hoop, you know, when I didn't have a gym. And especially Coach Oliver, you know, he just snuck me in the gym at Albertus, you know, days when I didn't want to go outside, me and my dad, and things like that. Just stuff you just don't forget, and you know, people you're always gonna keep in your corner. Especially, you know, last year, we didn't think we were gonna be in this position, and I just appreciate that, and I appreciate everything you've done for me, and you know, I just wanna say thank you from the bottom of my heart. You know, I love you, Coach, and just thank you. That's all I have to say. Thank you, parents. Thank you to my family, Sean, Quincy, Uncle Dwight, everybody for coming out here. I appreciate you, and let's sign this thing.
Smoking your day on me. I know that you do whatever for some Valentinos. I'm with the killers going to BET and Sativino. Man, my city was going crazy, rest in peace to Chino. And free that nigga Meech, cause he the hood hero. Don't gotta pull no point, we know. And wherever that drama at, we go. We the neighborhood hero. We the neighborhood hero. That street shit, we don't plot the niggas with that tweet. Beef said, fuck me, he ain't mean that sweet shit. Told him call the body, they gon' be there. Defense clock to his face, he won't eat it. You can snake me once and I'ma fall back. You say my brother, but he snake me, what you call that? I cheated on my BM 3 times with my dog at. She gave her number, I deleted, cause they all rat. Chirac, what up, police don't call backup. Last nigga play with Dirk Yo, he in the backwoods. Chicago niggas play with PNB, but ain't no matchup. You know me like you know me where I'm from, I'm not a rapper. Burglar, scammer, murderer, I'm handsome. When I'm off with drugs, I swear I steady throw a tantrum. Angelo told me once before he want a phantom. I can't say no, cause that's my son, I gotta answer. I know a bitch you do whatever for some Valentino. I'm with the killers, going to BET and Sativino. Man, my city was going crazy, rest in peace to Chino. And free that nigga Meech, cause he the hood hero. Don't gotta prove no point, we know. And wherever that drama at, we go. We the neighborhood hero. We the neighborhood heroes. They say we won't get help unless Obama do it.